So this video is about the functioning of DC motor, and we will be focusing especially on the functioning of commutator in this explanation. So now if you want to create a motor, it means something that can rotate. So if you want to create something that can rotate, what should be the first requirement for that? Okay, now look into that. Let's say that there is a body and we want this body to rotate. So will this body rotate under the action of this force? We say no, because this force tries to move the body in this direction. What about this force? This force will try to move in this direction. It means these random forces will not rotate the body. They will push or pull the body, but they will not rotate it. Okay. Now let's take this case, right? The body is there. Let's say there is some line. Okay. And the body is free to rotate about this particular point. And now we are applying force, two forces, which are equal, opposite and parallel to each other. Now what will happen under the action of these two forces, right? You see that the body is trying to rotate, okay? And the system of these two forces, such system of forces is called as couple, okay? So our first principle is now clear, okay? If we want to create a motor, the first thing we should be able to create is a couple. Now, if we have a body on which a couple is constantly acting in one direction, so the body will keep on moving in one direction only, okay, and it will not do any other kind of motion, okay. So this is our first objective. So let's just try to understand how can we generate couple that can act on a body. Now, to generate the couple that is acting on a body, we are utilizing a very important property of electric current, which is called as magnetic effect of electric current. Now, when you look at that, okay, the magnetic effect of electric current says that when a current carrying conductor, okay, is placed in a magnetic field, there is a magnetic field around it, let's say this north and south, and it has been placed under the action of these two things, right? What happens? The force acts on such conductor, and the direction of the force can be found out by Fleming's left hand rule. So here the magnetic field direction will be from north to south, from there to there. So current is upwards. So just use Fleming's left hand rule. First magnetic field, then current. Yeah, this is the force. So the force on this conductor will act in the downward direction due to the magnetic field. Okay. So now, by utilizing this property and changing the shape of this particular thing, because here only one force is acting, which is downward, and you have seen that if a single force is acting on a body, so body will try to move, but it will not rotate. Okay, so we'll try to create a couple, and to create couple we have changed the shape of this body. Okay, and let's say we have made it in this particular manner. This arrangement is called as a coil, okay, a rectangular coil, okay. This arrangement is called as a coil, a rectangular coil, okay. Out of this thing, okay, now, if this coil has been placed in a magnetic field, what will happen? If the current is flowing this coil, a couple may act on this coil. Let's just see that, how the couple is generated and how, what is the direction of that couple, right? Keep the idea in your brain all the time. If the direction of couple is same always, then the body will rotate, right? The direction of couple should never change. Then the body will work as a motor. Now, look into this particular case. Now, to utilize the property of magnetic effect of electric current, we have to set this thing on electric current. So, for that, we are using the first arrangement, okay? And that is permanently connecting this coil with external power supply. Okay, as we do that, okay, these are the coil ends A, B, C, D. So as we do that, this end is permanently connected with the positive end. So this is permanently positive and this end is permanently negative because it is connected with the negative end of the battery. Okay. So now what is happening? Let us take this coil is representing the coil in this picture, right? Okay, so when the AB arm, this is the AB arm, and this other is, this is the CD arm. Okay, Here, the arm AB is going to be connected with the positive terminal and CD is near the negative terminal. So, how the current will flow in it from the positive to the negative direction? Okay. Now, we have to see that what is the direction of couple that acts on the body and if the couple is acting on the body or not, first thing, right? So, let us see that. This is the first case of the coil, okay? And let's say that after 180 degree of rotation, the second case looks like kind of this, right? So, what should be the direction of couple in each case? If it remains same throughout, the body will do the complete rotation and our body will work as a motor, right? Okay. So, for this thing, okay, we have this coil here, A, B, C, D, okay? Where A is connected with the positive side. So, this is positive end and the other one is the negative end. Okay. Now, after 180 degree of rotation, AB side comes here. Okay. CD come here. Right. Okay. The positive is there and negative is there. Okay. If they are permanently attached with positive and negative end. Okay. This thing will happen. Now, if you focus on this thing, okay, what's the direction of current? In the first case, when the positive was here, direction was current was from positive end to the negative end. Okay, so direction was in this direction, in this way. So, in the coil, in the first case, the coil is having the current in this particular direction. Now, let's look at the direction of current in the second case. In the second case, it is in the opposite direction, from positive to negative, right? That's very clear from this particular thing, right? Now let us try and check that whether the direction of couple is same in both the cases and whether our body is making one complete rotation or not. Okay. So let us take the direction of forces in the first case first. Okay. So this is our body. Let us take it here. Okay, and in the arm AB, the current is up. Okay, use the Fleming's left hand rule to find the direction of force here. Okay, magnetic field in this direction. Okay, current is this direction. So, force on the arm AB is downward. Okay, downward. Force on the arm AB is downward. Okay, so what is happening in the arm CD? Okay, okay, the current is downward, force is this way, so magnetic field is this way, so current will be, magnetic force will be this way, okay, up, like that, okay. So, what is happening here, okay, the current, the magnetic field is pushing this side downward and pushing this side upward in that particular way, right. So, what happens that the coil tries to rotate in this particular order. Fine. After 180 degree of rotation, coil reaches in this particular position. Okay. So, this become positive and that become negative. What is the direction of forces on each side, left and right side in this particular case? So, yeah, this is downward. Okay. Magnetic field is this direction. Current is downward and the force will be outside. So, on the left side in this particular case, force is outside, or you can say simply up, outside. Okay. Now, what is in the right direction? Force will be simply, okay, this is the case, magnetic field, current and force will be inside, okay, downward or inside. Okay. So, now I just try and look into these cases, okay, in which direction these things trying to rotate. So, if the direction of force remains same in each case, we know that the couple will remain acting in one direction. In the first case, coil is trying to rotate in such a way that left side wants to move down and the right side wants to move up in this particular fashion. Okay. In this case, what is happening? Left side wants to move up and right wants to move down. Here, left wants to move down. Here, left wants to move up. Left down, left up. There is a problem because of that. Okay. The body will never be able to complete one rotation. Instead of that, it will keep doing the flip-flop motion. Okay. And when that is happening, we can say that couple is not acting in one direction. Here it is trying to act in this way, right? And here in the opposite way. So, our motor will not work because couple is not acting in the body in the same direction. Okay. Now, if we had some mechanism that can avoid this switch off current direction, okay. Now, if you use that arrangement and the current remains in the same direction, so we would have got the same magnetic field. We would have got the same force in the second case as well. So, the same couple in the second case as well. Now, one thing is very clear that this arrangement of joining the end of the coil permanently with the battery will never work because the direction of current switches and it becomes clockwise to anti-clockwise. So, the direction of couple is also switching. So, that's why the coil is doing the flip-flop motion. We need something here that can take care of this particular thing. That can avoid the change in the direction of current. Okay? Okay. And if we have that kind of arrangement, this is called as a split ring arrangement. Okay, we have it here. So, for the split ring arrangement, now we have seen that we have to avoid the couple switch in the direction of couple. We want the couple to remain in the one direction all the time. So for that we are using another kind of arrangement to supply current to this particular coil. For that matter, we are not connecting permanently in this particular case. We are not connecting the end of the coil permanently in this particular case. Instead, what we are doing, we have this brush which is connected with the positive terminal, another brush which is connected with the negative terminal. Let's say this is X and that is Y. Okay, so brush which is connected with the positive terminal will always remain positive, and the brush which is connected with the negative terminal will always remain negative. Okay. Now, how can I put this thing in the contact with this particular brush? So for that matter, we are using a ring like this. Okay, this is a disc. You can also use a ring only. Okay. Just you have to do the split, okay, you have to cut it out in two parts. So as you do that and connect with the terminals of the battery, it will kind of look like this, okay, clear. As you can see, one part is connected with one side of the battery coil and other is connected at the other end of the coil, okay. So as you do that, okay, you have two metal disc or metal rings connected at both the ends of the coil. Let's name them. This is P and that is Q. Okay. Now, is it possible to maintain the couple in only one direction by using this particular arrangement? If that happens, our motor will start functioning and it will keep rotating in one direction only. Let us see that it is working or not. So, this is the first initial case of the motor, and then let's say after 180 degree. If everything goes fine, the couple should remain in one direction. Okay. In the beginning, okay, think how things are working. Now, P is not permanently positive. It is positive until it is connected with the positive X brush. Okay. So, in the beginning, for this particular case, P is connected with the positive brush. So, it is positive. Okay. And Q is connected with the negative brush. So, Q is negative. Okay. After 180 degree of rotation, P will come there. Right, and P is now here. So instead of Q, after 180 degree of rotation, P will come there and Q will come here. Right, so after 180 degree of rotation, P is not connected with positive terminal anymore. P is connected with the negative terminal now. Okay,
So this is negative and here is your P. Okay, and Q is now connected with the positive terminal like that. Okay. So what is happening? What is happening to the direction of current in this case? You see that it starts from positive terminal, it goes to the negative like that. And what is happening here? It is flowing from Q to P, right? Positive to negative. Really well. Okay, we have successfully maintained the direction of current in both the cases in the same direction. Okay, so even after 180 degrees of rotation, current direction is not changing by utilizing this particular arrangement. Okay, so because of the current direction doesn't change, what happens to the direction of force? Okay, just look into that case. Okay, on this particular arm, force will be downward. So we don't need this thing right now. Okay, force is downward. So here it is down. Okay, on the right side, the force is up, outside. Okay, so how the coil wants to rotate here? Okay, the P end is there. Okay, and the coil wants to rotate in this particular manner, right? Okay, one end, the AB end wants to move in this direction and the other end wants to move in upward direction like that. Okay, so in the second case, what is happening? P is on the right side. Okay, so what will be the direction of force here? First of all, let's just put the direction of force. Okay, on the arm, this arm. Okay, let's just name these arm first, AB, CD. Okay, and here after flipping, AB will come there and CD will come here. Okay, so on the arm AB here, the force is acting up. Okay, and on the arm CD, the force goes down. Okay, now just have a discussion on that. On the left side, and the left side, force is down. After 180 degree rotation, on the left side, force is still down. And the left side, okay, on the right side, force is up. And even after 180 degree of rotation, force stays upwards. So what will happen? In the first case, coil is trying to rotate in this direction. Okay. In the second case also, the coil is trying to rotate in this direction. Okay. So what is happening? The direction of the rotation of the coil is not going to change because couple is acting in the same direction. And that's how your coil will complete all the rotations. And this is how we have successfully maintained one direction of couple that is acting on this current carrying coil. Okay, and it is always acting in one direction, okay, even after 180 degree of rotation. So this particular arrangement of split ring and the brush, okay, is called as a commutator. And this disc, this commutator is doing what? It is maintaining, it is helping us to maintain the direction of couple that is acting on a coil in one direction by maintaining the direction of current in one direction. Okay, so that's how couple is working, that's how commutator is working. Hopefully you have understood the functioning of the commutator of a DC motor. And the gist of that particular thing is, the conclusion of that particular thing is, the commutator is trying to maintain the direction of couple in one way so that our motor keeps on rotating in one direction. Okay, so this is it. Okay, that's the whole idea behind the DC motor and how it is working. How is it working? So, okay, that's it. Okay, I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care.